Hello, my name is Torbjörn Netland, and I'm heading the Chair of Production and Operations Management at the Department of Management, Technology and Economics at ETH. We are located in this beautiful city of Zurich, and we are honored to be part of ETH, one of the world's top universities. Oh, I didn't see you there. Did you know that production and operations management is concerned with the processes that transform inputs into outputs and deliver products and services to customers? Production and operations management is not just important in the manufacturing sector, it is also important in the service sector, like restaurants or transportation. Also, healthcare industries and governmental institutions have a lot to learn from production and operations management. Our purpose is to deliver research that matters and teaching that inspires, with the determination of making better operations in industry and society.
So, POM matters. Actually, not just for manufacturing industries. Also service companies or governmental institutions, education, healthcare have to think about how they organize their operations. Hey, a few of the things we teach in this course actually applies to your personal life as well.
Operations management is one of the major functional departments of a company, alongside sales and marketing, finance, HR and R&D. Did you know that the largest portion of assets and employees in most organizations are engaged in the operations function? POM is at the heart of any business. It is concerned with the productivity of technology, people and processes. In this course, you will learn about basic concepts and key principles of POM. No time to waste in a POM course. Have you heard about Michael Porter's value chain concept? It's a classic. Porter splits between primary activities and support activities. The primary activities consist of inbound logistics, operations, outgoing logistics, sales and marketing, and services. The support activities consist of procurement, technology development, human resource management, and firm infrastructure, which includes, among other things, accounting, legal, administrative, and general management. How well the firm balance and perform these activities eventually decides the firm's financial result or margin. While it is obvious that POM covers operations, note that it extends across all the primary activities from inbound logistics to after-sales service, perhaps with the exception of sales and marketing. Also note that all other activities have their own operations, which benefit from knowledge on how to do core activities as effective and efficient as possible.
So again, welcome to Production and Operations Management.